Okay, I just start the record. Okay. So this is the one numerical that we will solve today. Consider the data of the project as shown in the following table. If indirect cost per week is 200 rupees, suppose, okay, and find the optimum fresh project completion time. So here the question is asking about the find the optimum crashing means find the optimum crash project means what is the optimum crashing here, that you need to find out. Okay, so here means crashing means we want to reduce the project duration as with respect to trade off between the cost. Okay, so I just try to solve this numerical so you can understand how to deal with the such type of the problem. So first means in every crashing problem, as we discussed, first we need to find out the slope related to each activity. Slope will tell you how much means there is the means cost increment. If we want to decrease a particular activity by 1 week, then how much cost will be increased in that particular activity, that is nothing but the slope. Okay, and how to calculate the slope, there is the one formula for calculation. The slope is nothing but the crash cost minus normal cost, okay, divided by the normal time minus crash time. Okay, so in this particular activity 1 to 2, if there is the find, there need to find out the slope. How to find out the activity 1 to 2 slope? So there is the what is the means crash cost, that is the 850. Okay, so just write down 850 minus what is the normal cost there, that is the 700. Okay, and what is the TN means normal time for activity 1 to 2, the normal time is 7, so just write down here 7 minus what is the crash, actually that is the crash time, what is the crash time, that is the 4. Okay, so by use of this formula you can calculate the slope for each activity. And what is the slope for activity 1 to 2 that I try to calculate here. Okay, so 850 minus 700 is equal to 150, and 7 minus 4 is equal to 3, so it is a 50. Okay, so for activity 1 to 2 the slope is 50. Okay, like that you need to calculate the slope for each activity, that is the initial step of the crashing. Okay, you need to calculate the slope, and slope will tell you ke how much cost will be increased when that particular activity you decrease by per unit. Okay, per unit, here unit is the week. So if you reduce the activity 1 to 2 by 1 week, then what will be the cost increment, that is the mention here in the form of the slope. Okay, so 50 rupees will be increased if you reduce activity 1 to 2 by 1 week. Like that you need to calculate for slope 1 to 3 activity, for 1 to 4 activity. Okay, so quickly calculate and tell me what will be the slope for activity 1 to 3. 1 to 3 there is the crash cost is 700 minus normal cost is equal to 500, that is equal to 200. 200 divided by 5 minus 3 is equal to 2, so 200 divided by 2 is equal to 100. Okay, like that if you calculate for 1 to 4, then your slope will be for activity 1 to 4, that is the 200. Okay, if there any calculation mistake, then please let me know. For 2 to 5, okay. For activity 3 to 5, what is the slope? That is the 150. For activity 3 to 6, what is the slope? That is the 200. 4 to 6, what is the slope? That is the 125. Okay. Next one is the 100. 4, 5 to 7, and next one 350. So here we calculated the slope for each activity by use of this particular formula. How to calculate the slope? Slope is nothing but the ratio of this difference between the crash cost minus normal cost divided by the normal time minus crash time. So by I just give here one example how to calculate the slope for activity 1 to 2. Here we calculated like that, you can calculate for each activity. And why we need to find out the slope? Slope will tell you how much cost will be increased if you reduce that particular activity by a one unit. Okay, either here unit is the week. So if you reduce a particular activity by 1 week, then what will be the cost increment? That is the mentioned by slope. Okay, so if you dictate by this table, there you can see the normal time is 7, crash time is 4. So here you can't exactly compare all activity. Okay, the cost increment, if you reduce all activity by 1 week, then what will be the cost increment, that you cannot compare by this particular values. So that's why we need to find out the slope. Okay, now next, here the question is asking about, consider the data of the following project of the okay. Now if there is the indirect cost is the 200 rupees, find the optimum crash cost, project completion time. And okay, so that is the requirement. Now the first step means you need to calculate the slope. And next one, here what is the motto behind doing this crashing, means apply the crashing into the project. Crashing will reduce the time, or you can say will optimize the time and cost. By using the crashing tool, we can optimize the time and we can optimize the cost. Or there is the one more application, we can reduce the we can reduce the time of our project, but cost will be increasing. So that is the two thing. Okay, so here the question asking about the optimize the cost and time. Okay, now what is the time? Actually, first we need to find out what will be the time taken by this particular project, then only we can optimize that time. Okay, so first step, after that, after find out the slope, the next step, you need to identify how much time is needed to complete this particular project. Okay, then you can optimize that particular project time. Okay, so how you miss, what is the procedure to find out the time duration of particular project? First you need to draw the network diagram related to your project. Okay, after that find out the critical path, and that critical path will tell you what is the time duration needed. Okay, what is the normal time duration needed to complete this particular project? Okay, after that you can apply the crashing and all thing. Okay, so first we try to find out what is the time requirement to complete this particular project. So there is the first stage, you need to draw the network diagram. Okay, or you can say that is the first iteration one of your problem. Okay, so now I just try to draw the network diagram. This is the activity 1 and 1 to 2. Activity 1 to 2, just consider the normal time only. Okay, so here normal time is 7, so 7 is the normal time. So just write down here the time duration needed. Okay, in bracket you need to write down in the crashing how much you can reduce this activity 1 to 2. The feasibility of the reduction you need to write into the bracket value. So here how much I can reduce the activity 1 to 2, here normal time is the 7, the crash time is the 4. So how much I can reduce? The 7 minus 4 is equal to 3. So 3 week I can reduce the activity 1 to 2. So just write down here 3. Okay, so this is the normal time. The bracket value show you how much you can reduce the activity 1 to 2. So 3 week I can reduce the activity 1 to 2, that's why I write here the 3. Okay, now next, one, two, three, there is the 5 is the normal time. So just write down 5. Okay, what is the crash time there? Means 5 minus 3. Okay, that is nothing but the feasibility of the reduction. So 5 minus 3 is equal to 2, that show you the feasibility of the reduction in activity 1 to 3. Means 1 to 3 activity maximum you can reduce by 2 week. Okay, the next one is the 1 to 4. In 1 to 4, the normal time is the 8. Okay? And how much you can reduce this particular 1 to 4 activity? How much there is the feasibility of the reduction? So, if we see the activity 1 to 4, there is the feasibility of the reduction. 8 minus 5 means 3 weeks you can reduce this particular activity. Okay? Now, we completed 1 to 2, 1 to 3, 1 to 4. The next one is the 2 to 5. In 2 to 5, what is the normal time? Normal time is the 9. How much I can reduce this particular time? So, 9 minus 7, it will show you the feasibility of the reduction in the activity 2 to 5. So, in activity 2 to 5, how much reduction is possible? 9 minus 7, okay. So, that is the 2 week I can reduce this particular activity. Okay. The next one is the 3 to 5. Okay, so I quickly try to draw this network diagram here. The next one is the 3 to 6. If there are any doubt, then please let me know, class. 3 to 6, how much is the normal time there? Normal time to complete that activity 3 to 6, that is the 6. How much you can reduce? That is the 6 minus 5, means 1 week I can reduce this particular activity, that is the feasibility of the reduction. Okay, now next one. Next one is the 5 to 7. In 5 to 7, 2 is the normal time, and how much I can reduce this particular normal time. So here 2 minus 1. So 1 week I can reduce this particular activity. Okay. Now next activity is 6 to 7 and one more, 4 to 6 is I got one. Okay, so now this is your network diagram, okay, for your project. So, for crashing and for anything, first you need to identify how much exactly time needed, okay? So, how to identify the how much time exactly needed to complete that particular project by use of the means critical path you can easily identify, okay? So, how you can find out the critical path in your project? So, first you need to draw the network diagram. In network diagram, you need to find out all the path available, the length, you can say the longest path available in the network, that is nothing but the critical path, and the path length will show you how much time needed to complete that particular project, okay? So, I just try to find out the critical path available in this network diagram. So, paths available in this network, the one path is 1 to 2, 2 to 5 and 5 to 7. One path available is 1 to 2, 2 to 5, 5 to 7. Okay? So, with respect to what is the path length, that is nothing but this normal time addition. So, 7 plus 9 plus 2. Okay? So, 7 plus 9 plus 2 is equal to 18 weeks. Okay, the next you need to identify, next path is available here, 1 3 5 7. So 1 3 5 7, okay. In 1 3 5 7, what will be the length of that particular path? So 1 2 3, that is the 5 plus 5 plus 2. So, 5 plus 5 plus 2 is equal to 12 weeks. Okay. The next path is available there, that is the 1 2 3 3 2 6 6 to 7 1 2 3 3 2 6 6 to 7. What is the path length? That is a 5 plus 6 plus 3 is equal to 14 weeks. The next one, 1 to 4 4 to 6 6 to 7. Okay, so what is the path length? 8 plus 7 plus 3. So just add all this value, 8 plus 7 plus 3, that is nothing but the path length, 18 week. So can you tell me which one is the critical path in this network diagram, class? Which one is the critical? Am I audible properly? Class, am I audible?
Yes, sir.
Okay. So here, which part is the critical path? Out of, we found all the, means all the path length, okay? And as we know, the longest path is the critical path in the network, okay? So can you tell me, which one?
First and fourth, 18 weeks.
Yes, good, okay? So these two paths are the critical path, okay? So it is not means in many problem we found only one critical path. So it is not mandatory ki always one path will be critical. There are 2-3 path also will be critical. Okay, so here two path is the critical. Okay, that's why I taking this numerical for the crashing. So now here I just put this critical path. There is the double line, so you can easily see the critical path. 1 to 2 2 to 5 5 to 7, okay. The next one, 1 to 4 4 to 6 and 6 to 7, okay. So these are the two critical paths available in our network diagram, okay. So what is the means normal project completion time needed, okay. So I just write down here, because we consider all the time is the normal time, okay. So normal project completion time on the basis of your critical path length, you can easily say the normal project completion time is 18 week. Okay, so here normal project completion time is the 18 week. Okay, now means we know now what is the time needed to complete our project. Okay, now the next point, I want to reduce this project time duration. Okay, the crashing means I want to reduce the project time duration. Okay, so for reduction of time of project, okay, where I need to focus more on the non-critical activity or critical activity? Because we know that the time duration of project decided by the critical activity. Okay, critical activity means the activity present into the critical path, that is nothing but the critical activity. Okay, so here the critical activity are 1 to 2 2 to 5 and 5 to 7 for path 1, means for critical path 1, and next is the 1 to 4 4 to 6 6 to 7. These are the critical activity. So I need to focus on the critical activity, how to reduce the critical activity time. That is that should be our objective, okay? How to reduce the critical activity time? The first objective will be like that, because the critical activity decide what will be the time duration of your project, okay? If I reduce this activity 1 to 3, it will not reduce my project time, okay? Because it is a non-critical activity, but it increase the cost. Okay, so that's why you should be identify ki where I need to focus, which activity I need to reduce, so my project time will be reduced. Okay, so critical path decide what is the time needed to complete a project, so you need to focus more on the critical path, or you can say the critical activity. Okay, now here if you see in this network diagram, their activity, critical activity 1 to 2, 2 to 5, 5 to 7, 1 to 4, 4 to 6, 6 to 7, total 6 critical activity present in this particular critical path, okay, in this particular network diagram. Now, out of 6, where I need to focus, that is the next question. And which activity I should consider for the crashing? So my project time will be reduced. So in that condition, you need to identify ki which activity is the economical for reduction. And we know already slope related to each activity. Slope will represent how much cost will be increased if you reduce that particular activity. So on the basis of the slope, you can reduce the critical activity time. Okay. So now this particular path, there is a two critical path. So I need to reduce the one activity in this particular path one, okay, critical path one, and I need to reduce the time of particular one activity in a second path. Okay. So in both critical path, if I reduce the one week, okay, in both path, then my project will be reduced by 1 week. Okay, so I try to do, you will understand. Oh, just wait, I start the crashing. Okay, before that I need to find out what is the cost of our project. Okay, then only we can say how much cost will be increased if we reduce the time, and how much cost will be decreased, whatever. So the next point, we know the critical path. This one is the critical path. So I just write down here CP. This one is the critical path. So these two are the CP, means critical path. Now, what is the total direct cost? I just directly calculate what is the total cost or total normal cost of our project. Okay, how you calculate the cost of project? The cost of project, okay, the total normal cost of a project is equal to, you can say, the direct cost plus indirect cost. Okay, so what is the direct cost here? You need to calculate all the normal costs related to each activity. So here the normal cost is given related to each activity, okay, 700, 500, 600, 800, with respective each activity there is the normal cost is the given. If you add all these activity normal cost, that is nothing but the direct cost. Okay, so if I add all this time, that means all this cost will be 6,500. Okay, so this is the our direct cost, or you can say the direct normal cost, that is the 6,500 plus what is the indirect cost related to our project. So they are mentioned in the question. The indirect cost means I already discussed in our previous lecture. There means related to each activity one cost, that is the direct cost, okay, as mentioned here, that is the normal cost mentioned related to each activity, you can see here. Okay, these are the, means you can say these are the direct cost. What is the indirect cost? In every project you take some equipment, some resources on rent basis, okay, on rent basis. So the rent, and you can say that that rent and the loan, if you take a loan for that particular project, that continuously increase with respective time. Okay, so that's all the thing, the loan and as well as the on the rent rent based equipment in your project, equipment, or you can say the resources, that all the thing come into the indirect cost, and that continuously increase with the respective time. So indirect cost always given in a per week or in a per unit, like per week 200 rupees. So per week your indirect cost will be 200 rupees. How much time here the needed to complete a project, that is the 18 week. So if per week is the 200 rupees, then how much for 18 week, 18 into 200. Okay, so now the total cost is equal to 10,100. Is there any doubt how to calculate the total cost, how to find out the critical path? And the next point now, that is the, you need to select the activity, which activity I can reduce, that you need to identify. Okay, so already I discussed the path, and you can say the project time is decided by the critical activities. Okay, so which critical activity I should select for the reduction. Okay, so in economical way I can reduce the my project time, that is the objective of the creation. Okay, so I just write down here the critical path available in this in our network diagram. So just make one table like critical path. Okay, and what is the critical activity? And next one is the slope, or you can say if we reduce that particular activity by 1 week, then how much cost will be increased? That is nothing but the slope. Okay, so what is the means here? Two critical paths available, that is the 1257, 1257 and 1467. Okay, 1257, and with respect to 1257, what is the critical activity? The critical activity are 122, 225 and 527. Okay, for activity 1 to 2, for activity 2 to 5 and 5 to 7, with respect to you need to write down the slope. Okay, so already we calculated slope for each activity, that is the our first step of the crashing. So here we calculated the slope for each activity. And what is the critical path? Okay, in the critical path 1, there is activity this 1 to 2, 2 to 5, and next one is the 5 to 7 are the critical activity. Okay, so with respect to that, what is the slope? If I talk about the activity 1 to 2, the slope is 50. If I talk about the 2 to 5, the slope is 2 to 5. Okay, if I talk about the activity 5 to 7, the slope is 100. Okay, so I just put these three values into the table. 50, 225 and 100. Okay, the next critical path available in this particular project, that is the 1 to 4, 4 to 6, 6 to 7. Okay, so with respect to this 1 to 4, 4 to 6, 6 to 7, what is the critical activity that already present here? That is the 1 to 4, 4 to 6, 6 to 7. Okay, these three are the critical activity. And what is the slope with respect to that? 1 to 4, the slope is 200. Okay, if I talk about the next critical, that is the 4 to 6. 1 to 4, 4 to 6 and 6 to 7. So in 4 to 6, what is the slope? That is the 125 and 6 to 7, 350. So I just write down the values as well as the path. 1 to 4, 200 is the slope, already we calculated. 4 to 6, 125 is the slope, and next one 6 to 7, 350 is the slope. Okay, so now we know these are the critical path, these are the critical activity, and these are the slope. Okay, so these are the critical activity. Okay, and critical activity will decide what will be the time duration of your project. Now, which activity where I need to focus more, okay, for the reduction. So it is economically reduce the my project time. So here these three activity present here, these three present in both the path. I want to reduce this both path by one week. So which activity I should prefer? Can you tell me, class? Okay. So if I talk about the 1, 2, 5, 7, there is the time duration is the 18 week is needed, and I want to reduce the activity 1 to 2. Why? Because if I reduce the activity 1 to 2 by 1 week, it will reduce this path length. Okay, it will reduce this path length, as well as their cost increments is only 50 rupees. If I compare to other two activity, it is very less. Okay, that's why I choose this 1 to 2 activity for the crashing. Okay, so I choose this particular activity 1 to 2 for the crashing. Okay, so now if I reduce the activity 1 to 2 by 1 week, the path length will be, instead of 18 week, now the new path length will be 17 week. But I need to reduce this particular path also. Okay, if I not reduce, then my project duration time will be same 18 week, because now this one is the critical path 18 week. Okay, so in this particular critical path, which activity I need to choose? Okay, so just check which one is the economical. 4 to 6 is the economical.
Okay,
yes, good. Okay, so 4 to 6 is economical. Okay, I choose this particular one, and this is the for crashing I choose. Okay, next you need to think like that, can I reduce this particular activities 1 to 2 and 4 to 6? You need to check the feasibility by use of this network diagram. Okay, in this network diagram, we already put the feasibility of each activity. Okay, feasibility of the reduction of each activity I represented by use of this bracket value. Okay, so if I talk about the activity 1 to 2, I can reduce this activity 1 to 2. Yes, I can reduce this activity 1 to 2 by 3 week. And here we want to reduce only 1 week. So I can easily reduce. Okay, just check for 4 to 6. 4 to 6, can I reduce? Yes, because there is the feasibility of the reduction is the 2 week. Okay, so that is the, again I am telling you, in every activity there is the limitation to reduction in time. Okay, because every activity, suppose there is the housing project. Okay, and housing project is going on. Okay, and there is the foundation work needed, suppose 8 week, but that 8 week you can reduce by 6 week. Okay, by applying the more resources, by applying the more labor. But there some processing time is the needed. That's why you cannot reduce the below 6 week, because there some processing time needed to drying that particular cement and all thing. There is the some processing time needed related to each activity. Okay, so that is the limitation. So I can reduce this activity 1 to 2 by 3 week, and how to find out this limitation already we discussed. Okay, so I can reduce both the activity for the, so I choose these two activity for the crashing. So now I start the crashing here. That is, just assume that is the second iteration. Okay, so I just copy paste this particular part, the network diagram. Okay, if possible, no, it is not possible. Okay, I need to cut, just wait. Okay, so again you need to make a same network diagram which is you made earlier. Okay, so now I just put that network diagram here. Okay, this is the second iteration actually. Okay, so just assume that it is not here. Okay, now this is your network diagram, and as we discuss, I want to reduce the activity 1 to 2 and 4 to 6. Then we will calculate what will be the critical path. So I just reduce the 1 to 2, and you can say the activity 1 to 2 and 1 to 2. Okay, that is I reduce by 1 week. Six, and now there is the 2. Okay, now if I talk about the in the second critical path, can I reduce 4 to 6? Yes, you can reduce. So I just reduce, and now the new time instead of 7, 6 and 1. Okay, is there any doubt? Is there any doubt, class? Okay, so the next point, I again, can I reduce that particular activity? So how you will be checked? Okay, so I just want to check, can I reduce that 1 to 2 again by 1 week, and this particular activity 4 to 6 again by 1 week? So it will reduce the both the critical path by 2 week. Okay, that is the one concept. Okay, because there is the feasibility is the available. Okay, but first you need to check the 16. Now the new time is the 16. So can my critical path will be changed? So just check here. So all the remaining two paths, both the path are less than critical path. Okay, if 16, then these are the 14 and 12. So critical path will not change. Okay, so there is the more reduction feasibility in this particular part. So okay, I choose that particular one. I again reduce this one. Now 6 to 2 to 5 1. Okay, so if I reduce again by 1 week, then this one is the 5 1 and this one is the 5 0. Now this is the new network diagram after crashing of 2 week. Okay, so if I crash by 2 week, what is the critical path? Critical path will be same, because now the length of this particular critical path is 16 weeks, and other two path is less than 16 weeks. So these are the critical path, as we know, that is the 1 to 2, 2 to 5 and 5 to 7. And what is the path length? That is the 16 weeks. Okay, now if I talk about the 1 to 4, 4 to 6 and 6 to 7, 1 to 4, 4 to 6 and 6 to 7. What is the path length? 8 plus 5 plus 3. 8, 5, 13 plus 3, 16 weeks. So both are the critical path. Okay. And other two are less than 16 weeks. That's why I am not calculated here. But we know that the other two are less than 16, as we calculated in earlier our iterations. Okay. These are the 12 and 14 weeks. So that we will not consider here. Now, what is the project completion time? What is the project completion time? Now the project completion time is equal to 16 weeks. Okay, it is nothing but the project critical path length. Okay, now what will be the total cost that you need to identify? Okay, so what is the total cost? Okay, so I just try to calculate the total cost. The total cost at if our project time is 18 week, then project cost is 10,100. Okay, so I just write down here 10,100. That is the project cost at 18 week. Okay, at 18 week, and now we try to find out for 16 week, the total cost for 16 weeks. So 10,100, that is the cost of 18 week, minus how much you reduce the time duration. Here I reduce the 2 week of time duration, and we know that the indirect cost per week is the 200 rupees as represented in this numerical. Now if I reduce the project time by 2 week, then our indirect cost will be reduced 2 into 200. Okay, now what will be the increment? Okay, so if I reduce the activity 1 to 2 by 2 week, then what will be the increment? If I reduce by 1 week, then their cost will be increased 50 rupees. If I reduce by 2 week, then cost will be increased by 100 rupees. 4 to 6 if I reduce by 2 week, then the cost will be increased 250. So 250 and 100, so 250 plus 100, that is the cost increment of because of we crash the activity. Is there any doubt, then please ask me. Okay class, so what is the new cost? That is the 10,050. Here I reduce the time of the project. Now our time is the 16 week, as well as I reduce the cost of project. Are you getting my point? I reduce the time, I reduce the cost of the project. Okay. Now again I check, is there any feasibility to reduction of project and in an optimal manner. Okay. So the cost will be not increased, and can I reduce the project time? So that you need to check. Okay. So again I do the crashing. Okay. So for the crashing, you need to write down the critical activity or critical path, you can say. Okay. So I just without wasting the time, I just try to copy paste that particular part. Okay. So it will just save time. So again you need to draw, means here the critical path is the same after the crashing, that's why I put all the thing again. Okay, so it may be vary. Okay, there no not necessary ke your critical path always will be same. Okay, now this one is the 50 now, just wait. Okay, so class, can you tell me which activity I need to select for the crashing? Class, can this one is the 50? Okay, I am unable to erase also. Yeah. Okay, this one is the 50. Class, can you tell me which activity I need to select for the crashing? Now I crashed my particular project by 2 week. Okay, can I reduce the project time again? So I just try to apply the crashing again. Okay, and you need to check the same path is the critical path. So again I put the same thing related to slope. Okay, there no not necessary the same path will be critical in the each iteration, that will be changed, but in our case same. So that's why I just put the same thing again. Now again I need to check in 1 to 5, 7, can I reduce this activity 1 to 2, because it is a economical and it will reduce the my project time. But you need to check now feasibility, there is the feasibility is available to reduction that activity 1 to 2. Yes, I can reduce that activity 1 to 2 by 1 week. Okay, I can reduce. Okay, so okay, no issue. So I select again 1 to 2 for the crashing. Now if I talk about the this particular path 1 to 4, 4 to 6, 6 to 7, that I can crash or not, and then which activity I need to choose for the crashing. So it is a economically reduce the critical path length. Okay, so here I need to choose 4 to 6 because it is economical. But just check the feasibility. It is feasible to reduce. No, I cannot reduce because there is the 4 to 6 activity. You can reduce maximum 2 week. That is the feasibility available. Then and we already utilize that feasibility. Okay, now there is the 0 is the feasibility, so I cannot reduce that particular 4 to 6 activity. So okay, leave as it is. The second economical you need to choose. Can I reduce the 1 to 4? That is the second economical. So here 1 to 4, yes, I can reduce. So I just try to reduce by 1 week, okay. So I select this 2 thing and again try to make a network diagram and apply the crashing. That is the fourth iteration, okay. This one is the second. And I need to again copy paste this part. Just wait, it is about to end, okay. Now this is the network diagram, or you can say this is the iteration number. Iteration number 3. Okay. Now in iteration 3, I choose the 2 activity for the reduction. That is, if I talk about the 1 to 5, 7, there 1 to 2 I want to reduce. Okay. So I just try to make the next iteration with different colors so you can understand. So here 1 to 2 can I reduce? Yes, I reduced by 1 week and I selected only 1 week only, okay. So here you can see the next time duration for this particular activity is 4. And now their feasibility is 0. This is related to activity 1 to 2. Okay, new thing after crashing. Now next I choose the 1 to 4. Can I reduce 1 to 4? Yes, I need to select this particular I cut here. And now if I reduce by 1 week, the new time is 7 and feasibility available is 2 instead of 3. This is the new time related to activity 1 to 2 and 1 to 4. So now again, what will be the critical path? The critical path will be same, okay, because other two path length is 14 and 12 week, okay. And here I reduce the 16 week by 1 week. This is the 16 and I try to reduce the by 1 week that particular length, okay. So now critical path will be same. If you want to calculate again, you can calculate, no issue, but the path will be same, okay. So 1 to 2, 2 to 5 and 5 to 7, this is the one critical path, and the next one 1 to 4, 4 to 6 and 6 to 7. What is the critical path length? These two are the critical path, and now new length is 15 weeks, okay. Now what will be the total cost? So can I take the 16 week cost? The 16 week cost, we know that is the 10,050, okay. So I just put that 10,050 here. That is this total cost in 15 weeks, okay. Okay, so I take that 16 week cost, that is the 10,050, we know that, okay. Now I reduce the time duration of this particular activity, means 16 to 15. So 1 week reduction is there. So indirect cost will be reduced 200 rupees. That is the per day indirect cost in our project. That is the 200 rupees per day increase. Okay. Because I reduced the 1 week. So that's why I need to subtract that 200. Okay. Now, what is the cost increment related to our crashing? So I crashed here activity 1 to 2. So their cost increment is 50. And 1 to 4 also I reduce, and 1 to 4 related cost is 200, so I just add here, okay. So now the new cost will be 100. Now our cost will be increased. If you compare with the 16 week, there in the 16 week 10,050 rupees, now cost is 10,100. So again my cost is increased. Why increase? I just try to explain by using the graph. Just give me the 2 minutes and I will conclude the lecture, okay? So this is the cost, this is the time in x-axis, and we know that our direct cost, this is the direct cost. No, just wait, yaar, I made a mistake here. Okay, this is the direct cost, and this always related to your activity. Means we know that activity 1 to 2, if taking a 4 week time, okay, if what is the crashing? Means here you can see, again if I go quickly to the main part, okay, here you can see the normal time is 7. If I reduce the time duration in the direct cost, the cost will be increased. Okay, here you can see the cost will be increased. So here the 7, if I want to reduce the 7 to 4, the cost will be 700, will be increased till 850. So in every direct cost, there is the one concept as we discussed in the earlier lecture also. If you want to reduce the time duration, if you want to reduce the time duration of the any activity, then cost will be increased. Okay, if you reduce the cost of any activity, then time will be increased. Okay, there is the one more cost, that is the indirect cost. This is the indirect cost. So this cost is related to, if you take any equipment on rent basis, if you take a loan with a loan to the bank for that particular project, okay, so that continuously increase with the time. Okay, that interest rate and the rent will continuously increase. You need to identify this trade-off. The trade-off will, this is the trade-off and this is the total cost. Okay, so if I talk about the in week 18, what is the our cost? This is the, suppose assume that week 18, and what is the cost for week 18? That is the 10,100, as we found, okay, in this numerical. Now this is the, assume that this is the week 16. What is the cost? 10,050. Okay, now the next 15 week, this is the 15, the new cost is 10,100, and what is the 15 week is the time. Okay, so again our cost will be increased. So one time the cost and time should be optimum, and again will be increased. So this optimum point you need to identify according to your problem. So this is the optimum optimum cost and the time of our project is the 16 week and 10,050 rupees. Okay, are you getting my point? So if you apply the crashing, what is the optimum time here for the project after the fourth iteration? We can say the optimum time is the 16 week and the cost will be 10,050 rupees. Okay, so this is the all about the crashing. Okay, by use of the crashing you can reduce the cost as well as the, you can reduce the time. First you need to identify what is the time needed to that particular project, and that you can reduce that particular time, you can reduce by using the crashing. Okay, you can identify what is the optimum time and what is the optimum cost. If you apply the same type of the thing, then you can imagine this is the time taking is the more, 18 week, as well as the cost also more. Okay, here 10,100, that cost may be 10 crore, 20 crore in the big project. Okay, suppose 100 crore in metro project, there is the 3000 crore, like that cost. Okay, so how to reduce all these things? And their activity is the 5000, 6000 activity. How to perform all these things? By use of the software, you can apply the same type of the fundamental, you can apply in the software, and you can manage that type of the project. So are you getting my point? Is there any doubt, class?